In the beginning was the Word. Now in tune, on the one, the force itself. At this time we call it the Master Blaster Jammin'. As you know, I am the Rastafari Eitel Imani. The Rastafari Tapes, part the two. Rastafari was created under the subtle Majesty of his Imperial Majesty, the Emperor Haile Selassie I. Research, subtle, and majesty. Know its definition. The Rastafari movement was esoterically created by the subtle and the majesty of his Imperial Majesty, the Emperor Haile Selassie I. The natural man, the Eitelist, the natural man who lives in the hills, let's say the Maroon as an example, who have broken away from Babylon, who lives natural, grow his own food, instinctively understand permaculture, that man, that natural man who lives from the sun, under the sun, is technically a Rastafari. From a theocratic point of view, Rastafari are priest who's supposed to be in a temple carrying out the rituals of their liturgies. So we have the monks in the caves at Lalabala in Ethiopia who come out with their umbrellas, supposedly carrying the ark, which supposedly contains the covenant. These are priests. This is the duty of the Rastafari, the priest. So we have in the mansions of Rastafari currently the Bobo Ashanti. They are priests who carry out rituals, like the men in the hills who live naturally, growing their own food on another level, who claim not to be of the church, but who are independent spirits. These men are Eitelists, natural men. The Bobo Ashanti simulates the priest in the hills of Ethiopia. They carry out the rites and the ritual. Now there's another aspect of the Rastafari. It's on the esoteric level, it's the enlightened beings, the educated ones, the ones who know the allegory, the metaphor, and the similes. These are the sages. These are the men who sat under the tree like the Buddha, who heard the message and who contemplated themselves, looked back like John did on the Isle of Patmos. His eyes were red, his feet was of polished brass, and his hair was dreadlocks, lamb's wool. These are the men who have raised their life force over time, who became vegetarians, who raised their life force from the root chakra, traveling up the chakras. The Bible, they are called the seven golden candlesticks and the seven churches of Asia, as Jesus, when he was at about 13 years old, he started traveling the seven churches of Asia, getting information, learning in the priesthood. For instance, the temple at Egypt is one of those churches. So these chakras are power points or wheels turn This is Esoteric Side of Rastafari. You are now in tune on the one, the force itself, called the Master Blaster Jammin'. I am the Rastafari. I tall, I am an I, the natural man of natural faith. It is said of Noah in the time of the flood, by the faith of Noah, the elders, Anunnaki, were given a good report. So I am here delivering the message of the Anunnaki, the Rastafari. So we are the enlightened beings. This message I present to you is the refined information of the Rastafari who were in America. We were slaves. We raised our consciousness. We stopped eating the pork, the pig butt, and all that. And we became enlightened beings through studying, through meditation, and through fasting. So many of you out there saying this is not the message have never fasted a day in your life. Many of you have read nothing but the Bible and have no understanding of the Bible. Read the Quran, read the Bhagavad Gita, read the Upanishads, read the Lost Book of Enki. Read. It's not illegal yet. In the time of slavery, you were not permitted to read. Now the time of change, the Obama is here. Read. Learn. Be in tune. Know that the Master Blaster Jammin' is the Black Revolution. It is what we're supposed to be doing now. It's contacting the Anunnaki. The crop circles dictate. So you are now in tune on the one, the force itself, called the Master Blaster Jammin'. The Rastafari is a black man's redemption. It is a revolutionary movement.
Cool running, yeah. One more time, I'm back out.